Today, I continue my quest to make an entire underground layer to my Minecraft display with the addition of a dripstone cave. However, I have something kind of special in mind for this one, as I'm gonna kill two birds with one stone by adding in a mineshaft here as well. Both the mineshaft and a dripstone cave have been very popular suggestions ever since I did my first underground module for episode 4 with the lush cave. There is a lot to build in this episode, so without further ado, let's get started. Continuing with the rather dangerous trend I started a while back, I'm going to be making yet another very large module. This is the equivalent of 3 desert wells, that 8x8 block module I started this whole series out with, or 16x48 studs. As I learned from doing that deep dark module, these underground bits tend to take up a lot more bricks than surface modules do, just because they have to be so tall and dense. So I want to get started on the base of this right away using a mixture of water, stone, and dripstone. For the dripstone, you'll see I'm adding some intermittent texture with the backside of a dark tan masonry brick. Like LEGO's official rendition of the dripstone cave in their skeleton dungeon set, I've decided to use dark tan over medium nougat for the dripstone, mostly because medium nougat is already pretty frequently used as generic oak planks in many other places in this display. We want them to contrast, especially when medium nougat will be making an appearance here as the wood for the mineshaft. And speaking of the mineshaft, there's a few things I should mention before we get any further. This will actually be the second mineshaft I've done. I had a really small one appear in the Mesa Badlands, and I scaled it game accurate, but unfortunately game accurate doesn't always scale well to the minifigure. So this time I'm going to size it up just a little bit. We're going to make it one block taller and also one block wider. This is going to allow minifigures to fit underneath the support parts of the mineshaft, and it's just going to look better in scale to them. So for the wood planks, I'm using mostly masonry bricks to get that plank texture, the ridges, and you'll see that I brought out my TNT again to make sure I'm measuring this thing properly. My plan is to have it span most of this module, which is no insignificant distance. Good thing I have a lot of masonry bricks and medium nougat. You'll notice too, I have some Technic pinholes on the top of this thing. I'm going to be taking another liberty with the mineshaft, and because I think it's cooler, I'm going to have this thing hang from the ceiling rather than be supported from the ground, even though technically it would generate ground support since it's closer. I love the chain look though, and I really want to add that in this build, and I don't think anybody's gonna be too upset over that. Construction was going pretty well in the model, but this is the point that I realized I had made a terrible mistake. You see, the best part of my original mineshaft was completely omitted here, and that is the fact that I have no rails. One of my favorite techniques that I've developed over the entire series is my rails that first showed up in that Mesa Badlands episode, and I totally forgot to add them here, and so it was time to redo this. While that original module only had 4 blocks worth of rails, this time it was going to span the length of an entire chunk. I love these rails, you love these rails, and I cannot believe I nearly forgot about them. It's a pity to see all those masonry bricks not go to use here, but I think the rails is still a better solution. The technique I'm using here is exactly the same. Because of the pieces I use, they can only be done in 4 block long sections. Can't go any smaller than that, but you can definitely go larger. The two sections I'm making right now will go on to face each other, and then in between them I'm going to alternate medium nougat and dark tan 1x2 plates continuously along that path. It's going to be a lot of them, but it's going to get that great, very narrow rail look. The medium nougat is meant to be the background color of the oak planks, and the dark tan is the wood of the rails itself. Because of how mineshafts generate and because of the changes I've made to that generation, I will end up offsetting the rails by half a block, so it still centers in the 4 block long space. Thankfully, a 4 block wide mineshaft still gives me some room to actually re-add those masonry brick details on either side of the railway. I'm definitely getting closer to the point where I can add the first part of this mineshaft in, but I first need to tile off the bottom and add some detailing. That means smoothing this thing off with some 1x2 trans dark blue tiles, some 2x2 dark tan, and some 2x2 dark bluish gray. It never gets old. Plus, I'm laying down plenty of 2x2 jumpers, so I have lots of spots to put some Dripstone stalagmites. For the design of the Dripstone stalagmites, stalactites, I'll be using what LEGO included in the Skeleton Dungeon set, making use of the relatively new 1x1 pyramid piece in dark tan. That piece actually, in that color, just came out this summer. So I don't have a whole lot yet, but we'll make it work, I promise. We're getting very, very close to being able to lay down that part of the mineshaft now. I just need to add the other connection point on the far side of the module. The bridge spans some 32 studs and is definitely going to be susceptible to some bending, so I want to add plenty of supports where I can in the build. It'll just simply rest upon some tiles, but that should stop it from flexing too much. Plus, we'll have the chains holding it up from the ceiling at the end. So I put down the first part, and I put down the second part, only to realize I have screwed up yet again, and this thing is 5 blocks wide. It needs to be 4. Thankfully, that was a much easier change. I just shaved off some of the bricks on the side of the rails. That looks much better, and it fits. Third time's a charm, right? With that finally in place properly, I think things should get easier from now on. The roof of this might prove to be a challenge, but we'll tackle it when we get there. I'm liking the look of this. We got some good depth. The rails are fantastic. This is hitting the vibe that I want it to hit. On the far left side of the module, the mineshaft will become a little more traditional, breaking through the walls of the rock itself, and so we're just going to smooth everything out the best we can. And then I've also used these modified 2x2 bricks here, as LEGO has done many times in their own sets, so I can eventually fit in some fence-like pieces. As this is a mine shaft, of course, I want to suggest opportunities for mining. So up here on the far left wall, I'm adding some redstone ore. You probably noticed earlier on that there's some diamond ore really well hidden underneath on the right-hand side, and hopefully there'll be one spot to add some copper as well. Here's those fences I was mentioning. This is a design that has been used by LEGO since the release of minifigure scale sets in 2014. This is one of my favorite techniques that LEGO has designed for the Minecraft line, and it's awesome to use here. These are two pieces that don't look like they should go together, yet work together perfectly. It feels like the fences are connected to the side of the cave walls. It might give the illusion of stability, but these really aren't all that stable. They are just one by one stacked on top of each other, leaning up against something. So I want to make sure that everything above connects everything to the walls properly. And that gives me spots to add some inverted 2x2 tiles to get this looking as smooth as possible where I can. So, like I mentioned earlier, the 1x1 pyramid piece is relatively new and I don't have enough to do this whole module. So it came down to using either the 1x1 with the bar on it or the cheese slope. The cheese slope definitely looks better, has a more authentic Minecraft feel, and so that's what I'll be using for the rest of the stalagmites and stalactites for the Dripstone Cave. From a distance, you will not be able to tell at all. Hopefully one day I'll be able to swap them all out with the 1x1 pyramid piece once it becomes more readily available on Bricklink. To that end, there was one seller selling 18 of them, which is pretty good, but he had some of the lowest feedback I had ever seen on Bricklink, and wasn't about to make that risk. With the mineshaft pretty much done, I can build up the walls of the cave. I mentioned earlier I wanted to add some copper ore. I'm going to be using the same colors, again, LEGO used in that Skeleton Dungeon set. I love that set. It's just a mixture of dark turquoise and dark orange. I like the idea of having these dripstone columns look like they are the support of this cave, so I added 3 of them, kind of staggered throughout, as if they are large stalactites that eventually reached the surface of the cave and are now supporting the whole thing. They frame the mineshaft very nicely. Next, I need to start thinking about how I'm going to hang this mineshaft with chains. It's going to be one of the more complex techniques at work here. It was always pretty clear to me that I wanted to use official LEGO chains to replicate the Minecraft look, and because of that new 1x1x2/3 brick with a bar hole in it, I can actually connect them pretty easily and upright. So for the roof, comparing this to the deep dark, I have 3 blocks of space to go. My plan is, crazy though it might be, is to actually build the whole thing upside down. That will make hanging dripstones from it so much easier than if I had to do crazy snot techniques for each and every one individually. If the whole thing is upside down, it's a very easy platform to work with. Mapping it up to the existing module proved a bit challenging, but I came up with something that is going to work and is plenty strong. It's just going to rest on top. And of course, the best part of all of this is that it gets its own little tiling time lapse. You probably noticed here that there are four pretty obvious holes. Those, of course, are going to line up with the chains below. I want to feed the chains through those holes so that they can connect to the mine shaft below. Of course, I can't cut these chains to length. They are all set at a much longer length than what I need, and the short chains wouldn't work either. Simply flipping the ceiling upside down allows it to connect in place here, tile to tile connections, but it's not going to move anywhere because of all the rocks locking into place above. I'll feed the chains in through the four holes, and I'll do my best to center them using 2x2 rounded plates. The idea is to get that chain as close to the middle of the 2x2 opening as possible. We don't want to see the chains bending off to the side or anything like that. Of course, you notice that 1x1x2/3 isn't dark orange. I'm just waiting on a brick link order to swap those out for medium nougat so it matches and looks more like a regular oak fence. Let's add a few mobs in here. First off, I think this is a great place to have another bat. And it's essential to have a cave spider. LEGO has produced the cave spider before in 3 sets, but the thing is just way too big. Thankfully, a longtime viewer of the channel reached out to me, suggesting his own custom design, which I'm going to employ here. It scales so much better compared to a minifigure, because Tensor Brick has made use of this special 1x1 printed piece that was originally used for a cave spider spawner in the Mountain Cave set. I'll add this cave spider, a player trying to escape that, and a zombie for our player to unfortunately walk right back into. Mineshaft's a dangerous place. I've got enough parts for one more cave spider too, which I'll put on the far side of the module. The covered part of the mineshaft does get pretty dark, so I went ahead and added an LED above it. And now that we can see very nicely back into that space, I figure we should put something in there. How about a minecart chest? This is the same chest design that I used for the ice spikes, but I forgot to feature it. It's pretty simple, pretty straightforward, and it actually has a hinge piece, so you can open up the top. Temporarily, I'm going to be putting the pillager outpost on top of this just because it's my only other chunk and a half long module, but you can see here how this would line up. In reality, I'm guessing I'll put the mineshaft somewhere under the Mesa Badlands, so it might end up pretty close to the pillager outpost anyway. All in all, I think this is another really successful underground module. As I've started to play more Minecraft 1.19, I do think the Dripstone Caves is one of the coolest biomes. I hope I was able to replicate it here pretty faithfully compared to what you see in the game. The next episode is going to be unlike anything you've seen before in this series. I'm hoping to break down my design process a bit more thoroughly for this next module for a little longer in-depth video. Thank you as always for taking the time to watch this one. I hope you enjoyed and have a great life.